Welcome to BearTax. So if you go to www.bear.tax, you see our website where we have details. Here, when you click on register, so you can sign up for the application. You need to give your first name, last name, and then your email ID, valid one, where you need to verify, and a password. So once you sign up, you get a confirmation email, which on clicking the activate button, which says thank you for signing up with BearTax. Just click on the activate account, which activates your BearTax account, and now you are good to sign in. So use the same email ID to log in, and then the password, you're in. So once you're logged in, there's a home page where you have a dashboard. And the top three tabs is where you do all your things. So upload transactions, calculate gains. So first is get started. Let's get started. But we just click upload transactions. So it takes you to the next tab, upload transactions. So here we have all the APIs that we can connect and all the exchanges that we can manually upload the CSV files. If you have no files loaded, you'll have like no files loaded. Then you can refresh if you have already uploaded. On the right side, you can see the guides where you can connect to your various exchanges. So here's a guide for connecting the Coinbase, how you need to authorize and authenticate, and then the GDAX, how you need to get the API keys and secret and passphrase, and how to upload it into the BearTax. So similarly, a guide for Poloniex, how to get the API keys and upload it onto the BearTax. Yeah, so let's try uploading our Coinbase. So I click on Coinbase button, then it takes me to the Coinbase. My account is already logged in, so it asks me to authorize with specific permissions, the read-only access, and you need to check the URL that it is showing up. So it should be app.bear.tax with HTTPS. So once we authorize it, it comes back to the BearTax saying like it will take some time and you will be informed once it is done. So close it, so it will be in progress. It is showing like it's importing so many transactions from Coinbase. And then meanwhile, you don't need to wait for it. You can just go ahead and enter other exchanges API keys and secrets. So import your transactions for Poloniex. So we gave the API key and secret, click on proceed. So yeah, we schedule our jobs to fetch your data securely from Poloniex using API key and secret. And yeah, as you can see, it shows like it's in progress. So any transactions that you import, any exchanges that you connect will be shown in that middle row. So we give the API key and secret, fetch it. Then again, the jobs are scheduled to fetch it securely and you'll be informed. So it shows that it's loading, and it also shows like what exchange, what trading pairs it's fetching currently. So yeah, so GDAX, you can give your key, secret, and a passphrase. For Bittrex, you can give API key and secret and also the file. So you can read through the instructions there. So Bittrex has special instructions where you need to give API key and secret, which fetches only withdrawals and deposits, and you need to upload the CSV for trades. So we never store your API key and secret. You'll need to enter every time you want to import. This is for your security, and we only ask for read access. So you refresh it to see now we have the Coinbase completed. So once an API integration is done, so you see a green check mark with a remove button beside it. So when you click remove button, it removes the transactions that are imported from that API. So yeah, so now as you see, the Binance is also done. So you'll be notified automatically because we have the checking mechanism. So once you have all the APIs integrated, now the third step is to go to calculate gain and loss. Here you have uploaded transactions. So you can see like how many items have been imported and what are the type, buy, sell, withdraw, deposit, and buy coin. And you can change the pagination and number of items you can see in a single page. So you can go through all of them if you would like. To verify if everything is properly imported. Now we have a five-step process here. So it's like you're on upload transactions, you're done. Second, you need to go to review where we run all these things, then gain loss info, then payment, and you can download the tax forms. So once we have done this upload transactions, so we go to review where we run through all your transactions to see like all the deposits and withdrawals are being matched. And if not, we do a smart matching. We run a smart matching algorithm to put them all together. Then if we have any missing transactions, missing deposits, for which we couldn't find from the exchanges, maybe it's because somebody sent you or your exchange doesn't BearTax is not supporting your exchange, then we have some orphan transactions where we don't have deposits. Here we show all those transactions for which deposits are not there. This can be also referral bonus, this could be from mining which you have withdrawn from some address, things like that. So you need to provide proper input, proper deposit source for these things, for these transactions, so that now you see like you are going to get that. So here, list of transactions to be reviewed. What is this? So you have a clear explanation of like what actually this is and what you have to review and why you need to provide appropriate reasons so that everything can be calculated properly without throwing you into like negative balances situation or something like that. So it could be coin mining, referral bonus, it could be a forked coin, it could be an coin that's airdropped, or you could have received it from a friend, or you have sent it from different wallet or something like that. So select a source, select a date and fix the transaction, you're done. So here let's try for the first one. So I would go and select a source. So you have different sources here. So I am selecting received from a friend, which allows me to give a date time where I have purchased this, when I have purchased this. So I can provide a time, date and click on fix. That's it. We update the transaction with that date, 10 times, cost basis and put it there. So you can also select all and select this common source and apply for all. So once you have applied it for all, you can fix all review items. But here, like the first one is already fixed, so we couldn't apply that. So let's do a refresh. You can see a lot of transactions here because they're all referral bonus or something like that. So you can select other sources and apply it. But yeah, since the first one is already fixed, we need to refresh the screen. So let's go to upload transactions and come back. So when we come back, it again checks for orphan transactions. Since the previous one is already fixed, we won't get that again. So yeah, for the remaining things, let's select a single source. Let's be received from friend, apply. So all the dates are prefetched. So let's fix. So once we fix all this, then again we run and try to put them all together, matches. And if you still see some transactions, this is an interesting case. Like if you are using Binance, you might have got referrals and those referrals are never shown as deposits. So you need to find a, without having any deposit, you will be selling some coins. So yeah, let's wait for that. This can also happen in the form of a forked coin. So you are so you get an email saying like action required, tax calculation status. So here you're just one step away. You have to give the review, you have to review the transactions, missing sources, and then you are good to go and check your gain loss information. So clicking on that review missing sources will get you to the screen where you can review. So if you're holding a Bitcoin on August 1st, 2017 in an exchange like Coinbase, you would have got Bitcoin Cash. So that's a forked coin and you would be able to sell it. So there is nowhere it shows it as a deposit, so but you would have sold it. So suddenly there is a transaction which is sold. So we need to find a deposit for it. So such kind of deposits will be shown here where you need to accept that you have either got it by referral bonus or forked coin, or it's an airdrop one, or it's kind of an earning for holding other coins like NEO. For holding NEO, you get gas. So you would have a balance of gas which you can sell at a later stage. So that sell transaction will have a missing deposit, so for which you need to provide a source. So that's the information that's given there. There's a list of transactions for which we couldn't find either deposits or buy orders. So every sell should have either deposit or buy order. So if we don't have that, we'll show it here. So you need to agree by checking that box over there and submit it. Yeah, you can read through it, it's pretty intuitive. So you'll have all the information there. So once we check that box and submit it, so it again tries to match all of them and set them properly in the database, so that if now we have every transaction, a buy and a sell, or a deposit and sell, or referral and a sell. So every sell transaction has a source now. So there is no missing sources, that means no negative balances, which is much better. Like you on other platforms, you get like negative balances, which is like more confusing and you don't know what to do. So yeah, now it takes some processing time. So it takes some time to compute, match all these things and come up with the gain loss information. So hold tight and you'll see the gain loss information. Your gain loss information is done, calculated and ready to view. At the same time, you receive an email. If you're not on the platform, if you can close the tab earlier. So congrats, you view your gain loss status. So here you have a success message. You go ahead and view your gain loss. Woohoo! We have the gain loss information. So yeah, you have the, without paying anything, like even a single penny, you can see this dashboard here. So all the information, like the summary information for each coin, how much is your profit, how much is your loss, how much you made in gains or how much you lost. What's these are the taxable gain and losses based on your FIFO calculations. So till here it's all free, you don't need to pay anything. So only thing, once you have paid, you'll get some more information. So this is the difference. So till you have paid, you get only the summary. So the payment is simple. So based on your number of transactions, you'll be shown like what's your plan. So when you click, your credit card is processed securely by Stripe. So we don't store any credit card information on our servers. So yeah, this whole screen is presented by Stripe. So if you have a coupon code, you can enter that and you will be shown like amount of charge that your card will be charged today. Then yeah, you can just pay and come back to gain loss info to see more details. So the details that you see here are like actual transactions that are taxable. So what's the quantity that you have bought, sold, on which date and what price, like what's the total amount that's been involved. And what's the short-term gain, type of gain, short-term, long-term, and whether it's gain or loss. So you can see for different coins, when you have an audit, you have to show all this information. So that's why we give all of this. So on download tax forms, yay, this is the final screen where you can download your tax forms. So that's the 8949 capital gains form, or you can download a CSV. So when you click on download 8949, so you get the form. If you see the form, you have, there's a capital gains form that you have to include in your tax filing. So it has the information short term and what kind of thing, and all the coins that you have traded with their acquired date and sold date, total proceeds, and what's the gain or loss that you made, and things like that. So that's a detailed form that you can include on your tax returns. Or another way is you can download CSV if you want to send it to your CPA. Or if you're in a country that's not US and you need to use these numbers, then you can happily download the CSV. You have all the information for each coin here, everything that you have seen in the previous screen, the acquired date, quantity, date time, and total proceeds, gain loss amount, whether it's short term or long term. So this information is like used for audit purposes or to sending for CPA for him to upload into a custom software or something like that. Yeah.